NASA's mission to deep space and beyond has already started, with the Space Launch System being built as we speak. For its mission to be successful, each of its parts must work both individually and in harmony with all of the others. It's kind of like a stage play. Each individual performer has to know their lines, and they all have to be on the same page so they're telling the same story when the curtain goes up. So how do we make sure that SLS is ready to perform on opening night? Well, the rocket science version of Practice Makes Perfect is testing, testing, and more testing.
That's one small step for man.
Traveling through space is hard. That's why NASA's Space Launch System will have to be the most powerful rocket in the world. How is SLS able to meet the challenges of exploring deep space? Well, when it comes to our journey to Mars and beyond, there are no small steps.
So SLS is very far along, which is exciting. However, before NASA sends humans out into deep space, the rocket has to undergo thorough testing procedures, and there's just no way to rush that. Before SLS is boarded, each of its parts must pass a strenuous certification process. Now, the rocket's been designed, so we have our script, and all the roles have been cast, but we're not ready for a debut performance yet. In our other episodes, we've talked about how many different forces are at play during launch and space travel. The effects of each of those forces must be rehearsed, from the biggest to the smallest role. One recent rehearsal was the qualification motor firing, or QM2, which tested a major player in the SLS cast, the solid rocket booster. Now, as fun as all the smoke and fire of an event like QM2 can be, most testing is less dramatic, but it's still important. A lot goes on during engine tests, and it's easy to see that parts of the rocket are under pressure. But a failed stress test on a fuel tank might reveal a barely visible hairline fracture, which, despite its size, could still threaten the mission. It's kind of like how, if Romeo doesn't hit his big line,
"But soft, what light through yonder?"
Then Juliet doesn't get the cue for her line. Considering the various roles on SLS, let's take a look at some of the many tests that it has undergone or has coming up. Thermal vacuum, electrical discharge, debris impact, avionics power quality,
thermal protection system,
engine adaptation,
acoustic,
wind tunnel,
fit checks,
actuator,
base heating,
materials,
structures,
green run,
cold flow,
controller,
ultrasonic,
valves,
x-ray imaging,
flight test,
pyrotechnics,
shell buckling knockdown factor.
Whew.
So yeah, there's a good amount of work to be done. That brings us back to an earlier point. NASA engineers have developed extremely effective testing processes over the years, and they are dedicated to taking the time to combine these powerful parts with the care and precision they require. As with any performance, we only get one chance to make a first impression. Because of all of this thoughtful and rigorous testing, NASA expects the Space Launch System to get a standing ovation. Thanks for watching No Small Steps. See you next time.